Jenkins Church. Can I get somebody to give me some help with this? Oh, thank you so much, Sister Tracy. It's really heavy and I'm needing some help.
Okay, ready? One, two.
Okay, thank you. Whew.
All right.
Thank you. This will be perfect. We'll just put it right here. Oh, thanks. Awesome. Thank you so much. Welcome to Kids Church, and we are learning tonight about helping. So I had Sister Tracy be my helper to help. How many of you guys like to help others? I know whenever we have Kids Church like normal and Sister Amy needs helpers, everybody's, oh, me, oh, I pick me, oh, please, I want to pick. And I know that part of it may be because you get, you know, to pick out a prize or a piece of candy or something like that. But I think in general, a lot of you guys really do like to help. I know I love to help. Even like little kids, like even Felicity's age, she loves to help, or, you know, she thinks she's helping. But in general, I know we all love to help. And that's what we're going to be learning about tonight, or this time, whenever you're joining us, if it happens to be morning. We're going to be learning about serving others and how happy that makes God's heart. When we help each other and we serve each other, that makes God's heart so happy. So pay close attention as we learn about that this time. Go ahead and join me for the pledges. So wherever you are, you can stand on up. We're going to put our hand over our heart, and the American flag is over here in case you haven't picked up on that. So we're all going to pledge to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And then we'll pledge to the Christian flag, which is over here. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands, one Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again with life and liberty to all who believe. Awesome. You may be seated. And just real quick, I'm going to say a prayer for our lesson tonight. Dear Jesus, we thank you so much for this lesson. Thank you for all of the teachers that have put work and time and effort and prayer into this lesson. We pray, Jesus, for all of the young people that are watching, Lord, that they would be touched through this lesson, that they would learn something more about you and draw closer to you. And we thank you, Jesus, for what you're doing in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
It's time. It's time. It's time to sing to the Lord. Are you guys ready? Okay, so this one, you're going to need a little bit of room. So maybe move a chair aside, because I don't want you to break your arm or anything. Or you don't want to trip on anything like I would do. So anyway, get your room ready. And we are going to have so much fun, because this has got some motions. And it's going to tell you to do some different things. So ready? Get ready. Here we go. Hit it, Sister Heather.
I'm gonna sing, sing, sing. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout. I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout. Praise the Lord. Oh, when those gates are open wide, I'll be sitting by Jesus' side. I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout. Praise the Lord. I'm gonna clap, clap, clap. I'm gonna snap, snap, snap. I'm gonna clap, I'm gonna snap. Praise the Lord. For when those gates are open wide, I'll be sitting by Jesus' side. I'm gonna clap, I'm gonna snap, praise the Lord. I'm gonna stomp, stomp, stomp. I'm gonna jump, jump, jump. I'm gonna stomp, I'm gonna jump, praise the Lord. For when those gates are open wide, I'll be sitting by Jesus' side. I'm gonna stomp, I'm gonna jump, praise the Lord. I'm gonna twirl, twirl, twirl. I'm gonna curl, curl, curl. I'm gonna twirl. I'm gonna twirl, I'm gonna hurl, praise the Lord. shout. Gonna sing, I'm gonna shout. Praise the Lord. For when those gates are open wide, I'll be sitting by Jesus' side. Gonna sing, I'm gonna shout. Praise the Lord. I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout. Praise the Lord. I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout. And praise the Lord.
Okay, you're wondering who said yeehaw? Which one of you said yeehaw? I'm just teasing. Yeehaw! It's just a little fun song, you know, just to have fun. Praising the Lord, oh yeah. Okay, the third song. I'm in the Lord's army. You know, when I think of our military and how they serve the United States, they are helpers. They'll do anything wherever they need to be. You know what? I want to be like that for Jesus. And we want to be helpers. So we're going to do this oldie buddy, goodie, you know, and have fun singing, I'm in the Lord's army. Yes, sir. Okay, hit it, Sister Heather. And that's what we want to be, is in the Lord's army, doing our best for Jesus. So thank you, helpers. Did you have fun? Yeah, that was okay. Now it's time to learn God's word with the scripture memory verse.
Awesome job, praise team. Let's clap and give a hand for our praise team. They did really, really good. Good job. Okay, our PowerPoint is God loves when we help others. I believe that's what it is, isn't it? Have somebody check for me real quick. God loves when we help others. So I am here to help with the memory verse tonight. And whenever you, if I would ask you if you all were here, you all could probably raise your hand and say that you have helped someone. At some point, in fact, you're on the other side of the camera, but let's just do this. Raise your hand if you have ever helped someone, whether it was mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, brother, sister, a neighbor, a friend. Raise your hand if you help someone. So hopefully everybody's hand is raised, because whenever we help people, we feel really good. It makes us feel good. And not only does it make us feel good, it makes others who we are helping, it makes them feel good. So we are going to learn our verse. Our verse says, and we're going to do, because to help others, we need strength. So we're going to use this for help, okay? Help all who are weak. We're going to do this because we're like, I can't do the, well, mine kind of bag. But anyway, we'll do this for weak. Okay, help all who are weak, and be patient, like you're holding up a stop sign. So we're going to be patient with everyone. 1 Thessalonians 5:14. Okay, let's do that again. Help all who are weak and be patient with everyone. 1 Thessalonians 5:14. So whenever we think about this verse, we know that we have helped others, but part of the helping others, a lot of times it does us good to think ahead of time so that we are helping others on purpose. Okay, we are being intentional. And so if we would think, everybody just close your eyes for just a minute and just think about this week going to school or going to pre-K. In fact, you may be watching this in pre-K right now. So just close your eyes and just think of something that you can do this week, whether it's to help a teacher or if it's to help a friend or to help a family member. Just stop for just a moment and just think of one thing that you could possibly do this week. Now you can open your eyes. And this week, just think about that and do it. That would be you being intentional, and you would be helping others. So let's try that memory verse one more time. Help all who are weak and be patient with everyone. 1 Thessalonians 5:14.
Hello. All right.
Okay, good.
All right, so we've been talking about helping others, and I have the Bible lesson for you today. So if you want to grab your Bibles, we're in the book of John, chapter 13. We're looking at verses 1 through 5, and then we're going to skip a little bit and go through 12 through 17. So you can always go back and read it and look at it and just kind of review what we talked about today. Because we're talking about helping others. And helping others is an important part of being a Christian. And God wants us, he wants us to be nice to others by serving them. And so the Bible in John shows us, in fact, Jesus shows us how to be a servant. And the title of it, when you look in your Bible, it says, Jesus washes his disciples' feet. Yeah, you heard me, feet. Now, it was customary, you know, back in Jesus' time that as people were traveling and they had to walk wherever they go. And so they didn't have like covered shoes, they had sandals. And so they lived a very dry and dusty land, and so their feet, even though their body was clean, their feet were very dirty. And so if they went to visit some friends, they went to a house, a servant would come and wash their feet. And so in our lesson, Jesus and his disciples were traveling. It was before the Passover feast, and Jesus knew his time was coming short, and he wanted to show the disciples how important it is to help and serve others. So I want you to watch this short video about how Jesus did this.
Stories of the Bible. Jesus washes his disciples' feet. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He healed many people from their sickness, performed many miracles like calming storms, and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
At this time, the Jewish people were celebrating a festival called Passover that had been celebrated since the time of Moses, when God brought his people out of Egypt. So Jesus and his disciples went to Jerusalem to celebrate. Jesus had 12 men who followed him through his ministry. They were called his disciples. Jesus and his disciples gathered for one final meal together. Jesus got up from the table, took off his robe, and began to wash his disciples' feet. Jesus loved his disciples, and he knew the time was coming for him to leave them and return to heaven. When Jesus came to Peter, he said,
Whoa, wait.
Are you going to wash my feet? Jesus said, You don't understand what I'm doing now, but someday you will.
No.
Peter said, You will never wash my feet. But Jesus then told him that unless he washed his feet, he would not belong to him.
Oh, well then, okay.
Then Peter said, Then wash my hands and head as well, not just my feet. But Jesus told him that was not necessary. He just needed to wash his feet for Peter to become clean. So Jesus finished washing their feet and said that the disciples should do to others as he had done for them. He told them to follow the example that he had set for them, to serve each other and not think of themselves as greater than any other. Then God would bless them for doing as Jesus had taught them to do.
Wow, think about this. Jesus, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, showing the disciples that he is not better than the servant. He was showing them that it is important to be a servant to others. And he washed their feet. That's the way of showing love and kindness of his ways and his goodness to others. And so the disciples, he wanted the disciples to know that you are not better than anyone else either. And it's important to serve others. Now, today we don't really wash feet when people come over to my house. My sister was over the other day. I didn't wash her feet. And I went over to my sister's house the other day, and guess what? She didn't wash my feet either. So we have to think about how can we help others. Sister Lorena talked about it. You know, there's so many different ways, you know, that we can be hands and feet of Jesus Christ. Sometimes it's just simple as a smile. You have no idea what that person is going or facing that day, and that smile might just make the world of a difference, because we demonstrate so much by what we do rather than what we say. In fact, you might have heard that saying before, that actions speak louder than your words. And so how we treat people is so important. And Jesus is showing us that our kindness and our good, that we need to share that with others. And so let's not say we want to help you. I'd like to help you. Let's be that help for that person. Let's be that positive attitude, that positive light for them. Be the light of Jesus for this. Because you know what? You know what the Bible says? Now, it's not just the Bible. It's in red. That means Jesus said this. He said, if you do these things, he says, Now that you know these things, you will be blessed if you do them. And it's so true. It's so true. You might think, oh, I probably should go help that person out. I got to get off the couch, you know. But it's almost like when you get up and you start helping each other, you are more blessed. It's just an amazing, indescribable feeling when you start giving your time and helping others in situations. It is a blessing. And so let's follow Jesus' example. Let's be that kindness, that goodness, that help to others, because that's what God wants us to do.
All right. Hi, boys and girls. It's your neighborhood Spider-Man. Not really. It's just Jesse. Yay. Not yay. Anyways, so we've learned a lot so far, and we're going to keep learning because learning is fun. Yay. Everybody say yay. Like you mean it. Yay. Yeah, I meant it right there, right? Anyways, so story time. This is going to be fun, except we got to set up some ground rules, okay? Everybody say yay. We love rules. Yay. All right. Ground rules are for this story time. Whenever I say Tommy, everyone's going to say Tommy, just like that. So when I say Tommy, everyone's going to go, there we go. You guys did it. Good job, everybody. Round of applause. And now this next one's a little bit trickier, okay? This is a little harder, so get ready. When I say Mr. Jenkins, what was his name? See, I just forgot his name. Oh, yeah. Old Man Jenkins. We're going to say, you kids, get off my lawn. Just like that. Not really, because that's a lot of stuff. Let's see. What's something more fun that we can say? Ooh, you young whippersnappers. Just like that. We're going to say that, all right? So when I say, Old Man Jenkins, you whippersnappers, you youngins. That's what you're going to do, okay? Great. All right. So when I say Tommy, you're going to say, Tommy. And when I say Old Man Jenkins, you're going to say, you old whippersnappers, you. Yeah, just like that. Just like old grandpa. You know, you guys all have a grandpa, right? You guys know what old people sound like. Anyways, so, all right, one day, this is where the story starts, so this is what you're using. One day, Tommy was outside playing basketball, and, you know, he was, what is it called? He was making touchdowns, right? Yeah, when he was throwing the balls or whatever. It's touchdowns, right? Correct me? No, it's not touchdowns. Okay, so anyways, Tommy was making field goals. He was making field goals like that or home runs or whatever with the ball. And then he noticed, well, you guys didn't say Tommy, did you? Tommy, there we go. We'll keep trying. All right. And then he noticed Old Man Jenkins, you whippersnappers, you. He was walking out because it's his neighbor. He lives right next to him. That's why he sees him. He was walking out, you know, kind of limping, carrying a trash can. And he was struggling, kids. Let's just say he was struggling. He needed to go sit down. So Tommy was like, hey, can I help you with that? So he goes over and he's like, oh, sure, you know, take the cans. So he took the cans out because, you know, you don't want to miss trash day. Believe me, when you get older, trash day is a good day and you're going to remember that. So anyways, so Tommy takes the trash cans out to the front, you know, and Old Man Jenkins, you whippersnappers, went back inside and everything. As Tommy was going back to go make some more free throws and goals and volleyball, whatever, he noticed Old Man Jenkins, you whippersnappers, his car was a little dirty. And he was like, huh, well, I don't think he can clean it because I don't think he's very healthy right now. So Tommy decided he was going to grab a rag. I had a rag somewhere, actually. Wait, oh. He was going to grab a rag. That was a cool trick. It was like a clown trick, you know, for my next trick. Anyways, he was going to grab a rag. And he went over and he started washing Old Man Jenkins, you whippersnappers, car. And this is getting hard, all right? I just want you to know I'm putting a lot into this. So he went over and started washing his car.
One eternity later.
Imagine this, you know, really old guy, whatever mowing sounds. I don't know if you guys know what a lawnmower is. Hopefully you guys do. That sound, we're just going to pretend you know, whatever. He's like, yeah, there's a reason that grass is pretty long. So he's like, huh, maybe I can go mow it for him. So he goes on, you know, and he goes, you know, that was a pretty cool sound effect. Yeah, that was me. That was my foot, in case you didn't see it. That was over there. So anyways, he goes over and he asks Old Man Jenkins, you whippersnappers, if he can mow his yard. And he's like, yeah, sure, you know, Tommy, he can do it. So Tommy, spends the next hour or two just mowing the yard, you know. And let me tell you, after he was all done, Tommy just looked back and he's like, man, yeah, Tommy, you got it. Good job. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Woo, man. He finally finishes, and so he goes over, and he's just like, whoo. Here, we'll go. Whoo, I am tired, said Tommy. And he's just so tired. So he goes back inside, and he goes into his house, and he decides, you know, it's about dinner time. His mom's ringing the cowbell, you know, come on, get it, yeah, you know, ding, ling, ling, ling. I don't know if your parents ever do that. Mine did once, but anyways, he goes, and then out of nowhere, as he's eating dinner, all of a sudden you hear, and he's like, huh, that's weird. I don't think my friends were supposed to come over today, but somebody's at the door. So he goes over, and to his amazement, there's this bag that's just sitting there at the door, and his name's on it, which is his name is? Yeah, there you go. You're getting it. We're getting this. So he's like, is this for me? That's weird. So he opens the bag, and there's just stuff in there. And he's like, hey, look, it's a Frisbee. Cool. All right, I got a Frisbee. And some, what is those, basketball shoes? This is going to make me jump really high. And just all this cool stuff. And he's like, I didn't ask for this stuff. Why did he? And then as he was looking outside, there's old man Jenkins, you whippersnappers, just walking back to his house. And he's like, hey, thanks. And he's like, yeah, because he couldn't really hear very well. That's why. So the whole story is Tommy was more focused on helping out somebody else. He didn't do it because he was like, oh, man, maybe if I do this, I'll get this thing or I'll get that thing. No, he decided that he needed to help somebody. And at the end of the day, I think the best part about all of that wasn't the stuff that he got, but it was the feeling in his heart that he really did something for somebody that they couldn't do on themselves. Old man Jenkins, you don't have to do that. Old man Jenkins could not have done all that thing probably in one day. He probably needed help because, you know, when you get a little older, let me tell you, let me preach right now for you. When you get a little older, you're going to need some help. So in like 20 years, I'm going to need some of you guys to come wash my car and I'll come call you whippersnappers. But sometimes it's really nice when you go out of your way to help somebody else out, knowing that you didn't ask for anything. All you did it was out of the kindness of your heart. Because sometimes, well, all the time, Jesus does things for us out of the kindness of his heart. He didn't expect anything out of it. He didn't expect, you know, you to, oh, hey, here's $20 for that thing that you did for me, Jesus. All right, buddy. No, he said, I love you, and I want to give you this, and I don't expect anything in return. So the whole question that I'm going to leave you with is, when's the last time you did something nice for somebody? Whether it's wash their car, mow their yard, right? There's like three words in there. Or just tell somebody, hey, you know what, Jesse, brother Jesse, a lot of people don't think you're funny, but I think you're okay. See, that's all you need. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's all. That's it for me. We're going to move on to the next lesson. So, you whippersnappers!
All right, so I guess you've kind of gotten the idea of what we're talking about tonight, that God is pleased when we help others. God loves it when we help others. And that's because we are the hands and feet of Jesus. And, you know, he could come down and do all this stuff himself, but he wants us to be his hands and feet because that's how we help others to see Jesus. They see him in us. Anyway, so Sister Rebecca asked you, and I think a couple others have asked you, have you ever helped someone? And I'm sure that most of us, if you have not, you need to try it because it is a wonderful blessing. You think, oh no, helping somebody just is work for you. No, actually, you will receive something from it. And that what you receive, that which you receive is what you get on the inside. And so if you've ever helped somebody, you'll know what I'm talking about, especially if it's somebody who really needed help. When you provide for them or you help someone, something happens on the inside of you. Now, I'm a practical person. I like to think practically. So I'm thinking, okay, so how is it that these young people, you, can help others? And I'm going to start in the home. Let's just start real quickly in the home. Say you come into the house and your little sister, your little brother has been messing in the living, you know, playing and messing around, and they've made a big old mess on the living room floor. And you can see it needs to be vacuumed. So you could just pretend like you don't see it, even though your mother, man, she does work hard for you. And but you could just walk away and say, oh, I don't know, maybe mom will see that and get it later. Or you could go run and get the vacuum cleaner, and I'm going to come right back, and I'm going to take this vacuum cleaner, plug it in, and vacuum this up. And I'm going to make mom so happy because she's going to be so surprised when she comes into the living room and all of this mess is cleaned up. I know that's going to make her so happy. And you know what happens? Something happens on the inside of you. There's a feeling of accomplishment and joy
that you get when you help others. You know, if you just live selfishly, guess what happens? You're never satisfied. You're never completely happy. When you live just for yourself, you're always reaching for something else. I want, I want, I want. I hope that you understand that a lot of the times the reasons we don't want to help somebody are purely selfish, and that does not please the Lord, because Jesus was the opposite of selfish. He was the one that always gave of himself. And so Jesus knows the true joy that comes from giving, and that's what I want for you. Say you're walking down the hallway at church or at school, and there's a piece of paper on the floor. You could just walk right past it. No one's ever going to know if you pick it up and throw it in the trash can. Or is there? Somebody does know when you do it. First of all, you know when you reach down and pick up a piece of trash and throw it in the trash can that you have done the right thing. But somebody else is also watching all the time, and that's the Lord Jesus Christ. He watches us as we live our lives, and he wants us to be the best that we can be. And, you know, I'm trying to think of any of the other ways that you can do it. If somebody's walking through a door, their hands are full, open the door for them. Give them a smile. If you can see that there's dirty dishes in the living room because people have been eating in the living room, and so you gather up the dirty dishes and bring them into the kitchen and wash them, or put them in the dishwasher for your mom so that she doesn't have to do it. There's so many ways that you can help others, in addition to your friends or people around you that you see that need help. Or if they're feeling sad and you just offer a kind word or a smile or reaching out to them in some way, these are ways that we can be the hands and feet of Jesus in this world. And that's what pleases the Lord, is he wants us to be his hands and feet. And you will receive a joy in your heart that comes like nothing else. I can't explain it. I learned it a long time ago when I was a little girl, how helping others brought me joy as well, made me feel good about myself. And so that's what will happen for you as well, because living selfishly never will supply your needs. It will never. I promise you that. You'll always feel unsatisfied. But so allow God to work through you. Think of ways that you can become a help to others. All right, well, we're going to pray, and we're just going to ask the Lord to lead us in a way that will help us to be the brightest light that we can be in the world that we live in today, and just to guide us in our way every single day, and to help us to see, be wise, to be discerning, to pay attention so that we can see things and people who need help. All right, let's all close our eyes and let's pray together. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for each one who's hearing this lesson today. We know, Lord, that when we are your hands and feet, God, that you can accomplish much in this world. And Lord, that it pleases you when we do things that are thoughtful and caring of others. Lord, that we show your love to others, and we will help them to see the truth of you in us. I pray, Lord Jesus, that your anointing would just rest upon us. Help us to have wisdom, discernment, to be aware, God, and to see those things around us that need to be done, and to care for others enough to not just live for ourselves. I thank you for it. I want to give you all the praise and the glory. With this life I have to live, we only have one, and I want to do it for your glory and for your honor. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. All right, we'll see you all next week. We're looking forward to it.
You whippersnappers!